Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Incarnation. I am Christian Canquisto, one of the organists at Peabody Conservatory. And we'd like to thank the Cathedral of the Incarnation, as well as Dr. Ken Brown, the organist here, and also Miss Sally Swiger for scheduling our practice time. We'd like to really thank you for the use of this space to have a Halloween concert here. And so to begin, we do not have a set program because of a few last minute changes. And as such, I will be the one to introduce each piece in turn. We have 8 pieces in total. Total concert time is around an hour. And so to begin, we're going to have Paul play for us Bach's Toccata and Fugue in D minor, BWV 565. That was quite the lovely opening, wasn't it? So now we're going to transition to another toccata in D minor, but instead of Bach, it will be by Bach's role model, Buxtehude. And performing this will be Kevin. So here is Buxtehude's toccata in D minor. Thank you. for the next piece, I'm going to be playing Bach again. So this is not Bach's original work. It is actually a transcription from his St. Matthew's Passion by Professor Benjamin Rigetti all the way at Switzerland. And so this piece is originally for strings, a violin solo, and an alto voice. And so you will hear all of those in the form of an oboe on one manual. I'm going to be thumbing the alto solo. My left hand will take care of the strings, and then the basso continuo with my pedals. And so here's the Erbarme dich, Lord have mercy on me, from St. Matthew's Passion.
Thank you.
And so our next piece is going to be another toccata, but we're going to venture away from this German Baroque tradition that opened this program, and now we're going to hear a French toccata. It is Bollmann's toccata from Suite Gothique, and Kevin will be playing this piece. Thank you. continuing along the French Romantic period, the next piece is by Louis Vierne, the blind organist at Notre Dame Cathedral. He has a collection of 24 fantasy pieces, and Midori here is going to play one of them, titled Feu Follet, or Will-o'-the-Wisp. It's like, a Will-o'-the-Wisp is one of those like mythical creatures. They act kind of like fireflies, they light up in the forest, but they're much more random than that. And so you'll hear that in this next piece. Thank you. To conclude the French Romantic portion of this program, I will be playing the first movement of Charles-Marie Vidor's Organ Symphony No. 6. The term symphony is usually reserved for an orchestra, but a big idea in the French Romantic repertory is that the instrument is conceived more of an orchestra, and so here Charles-Marie Vidor uses symphony instead of sonata. This is actually my favorite organ piece ever, and I hope I can convey that through my playing.
Thank you.
So we went through the German Baroque, the French Romantic, and now that leaves American Contemporary. And so the next piece we have is by Chelsea Chen, an American organist here, and she composed a piece called the Taiwanese Suite, and which utilizes folk songs from Taiwan. And so Midori will be playing for us a movement from that piece called Moonlight Blue. To conclude the program, I will be playing an arrangement of a pop tune, actually, Michael Jackson's Thriller. I originally wrote it for my high school in order to use their Hammond organ for their own Halloween event, but I figured why not do it on pipe organ as well. And so, Michael Jackson's Thriller. Thank you very much for attending this hour of your Halloween for this concert. So if you have any questions about the program, because we didn't have it on paper, feel free to come to me because I'll be here for a few more minutes. Feel free also to follow the Peabody Organ Department page on Facebook, which is where we will put our updates for other organ events that you may or may not be interested in. But nonetheless, happy Halloween. Thank you very much.